A report from Cleveland.com showed that the Browns wanted to move for Terrelle Pryor Sr. before the NFL trade deadline, but the Redskins would not part with their wideout. Many fans want to know, why not? Through 8 games, Pryor has not produced much in Washington. He has 20 catches for 240 yards and 1 touchdown. Last month, Pryor even apologized via his Instagram feed for his poor performance with the Redskins, after losing receivers Pierre Garçon and DeSean Jackson last offseason. Many expected Pryor to step in and have a huge year in Washington, teamed up with Kirk Cousins and put into an effective Jay Gruden offense. The theory made sense. It hasn't happened. Pryor has been plagued by suspect hands and subpar route running. At the same time, he has all the physical tools to make an impact, like he did last year in Cleveland, with significant usage in the Browns' offense in 2016. Pryor went for over 1,000 yards receiving. In Washington's offense, where Cousins moved quickly through reads, Pryor is not getting close to the target count he got last season in Cleveland. So again, why wouldn't the Redskins brass want to trade Pryor? Two reasons jump out. Pot committed. The Redskins signed Pryor to a 1-year, $6 million contract. $3 million of that came in the form of a signing bonus, and with 8 games done, he's already earned another $1.5 million in salary. Considering the Redskins have already paid 75% of the contract, the team must want to see what they can get out of Pryor in the remaining 50% of the season, up the ante. In the NFL, almost any player can be moved if the offer comes in high enough. The Browns would have already been getting a value for Pryor, just based on the contract structure. It's unlikely they offered much to acquire their former star wideout, especially considering Cleveland is in the middle of another terrible season and could chase Pryor in free agency this winter. One last thought: it might be premature to close the door on Pryor delivering some value for the Redskins this season. At this point, he will certainly not play up to off-season expectations, and another 1,000-yard season won't happen, but if the Redskins want to make a December playoff run, a big, athletic wideout might help maybe. Want more Redskins? Click here to follow JP on Facebook and check out at JPFinLarryBesees for live updates via Twitter. Click here for the Redskins doc on Apple Podcasts, here for Google Play, or press play below. Don't forget to subscribe. Here is what you need to know on this Sunday, November 12th, 7 days before the Washington Redskins play the New Orleans Saints at Mercedes-Benz Superdome. Timeline: today's schedule. Redskins stock tailgate, orange latte, look for the satellite truck, 11 a.m. Redskins kickoff noon, NBC Sports Washington Redskins vs. Vikings 1 p.m. Fox days until Redskins at Saints 119-7, Giants at Redskins Thanksgiving 11-23-11, Redskins at Cowboys Thursday night 11-30-18. Key Redskins injury updates: out Ioannidis hand, DeJones shoulder questionable, W.R. Crowder hamstring, Tay Reed hamstring, T. Williams knee, G. Scherf knee, C. Long knees, T. Nsekhe core muscle, Tay Paul concussion. Full injury report here. The headliner is that Trent Williams practiced for the first time in over a month, and there are reports that he and Jamison Crowder will play on Sunday. Final thoughts on Redskins versus Vikings latest injury news. According to media reports this morning, the Redskins will have Jamison Crowder and Trent Williams in the lineup, but Jordan Reed's hamstring will keep him out for at least another week. Crowder had his best game of the season with 123 receiving yards against Dallas before sitting out with a hamstring in Seattle a week ago. Williams practiced for the first time in over a month on Friday. While his knee will not be fully healed until he gets surgery, he still is the best option to keep defensive end Everson Griffin, who has 10 sacks on the year, out of the backfield. Strength of schedule: the Vikings are 62 and they have won 4 games in a row against teams that are currently .500 or worse. Overall, their opponents have won 29 games and have a .446 winning percentage. The Redskins are 44 against the toughest schedule in the league. 5 of their opponents are in the if the season ended today playoff picture, and the Cowboys are just a half game out. Their opponents have won 43 games and they have a .614 winning percentage. If Washington and Minnesota had played each other's schedules in the first half of the season, it's reasonable to think that the Redskins would be 62 or maybe 53, while the Vikings would be 44. Two-back attack: the Vikings come at you with two running backs, Latavius Murray 249 yards rushing on the season and Jerick McKinnon 287. The Redskins will try to keep them under wraps and make pedestrian QB Case Keenum try to beat them. Since the start of the 2015 season, the Redskins are 9,121 when they allow more than 100 yards rushing, so they aren't dependent on stopping the run to win games, but it does help. Other winning factors for the Redskins: get to Keenum. He has been sacked twice in each of the Vikings' 2 losses, only once in games where he played and the team won. be a little better than average. The Redskins have averaged 22 points per game this year. Under Mike Zimmer, the Vikings are 29 when their opponent scores more than 24 points. Hold on to the ball. This is always good advice, but particularly in this game. The Vikings have 10 takeaways in their wins and none in their losses. Prediction: well, maybe it's not a great idea to listen to me here because I haven't had a good feel for how the games would turn out so far this year. But I think this is a game they win and perhaps one they win easily. The Redskins should have Williams back at left tackle and Brandon Scherff returning at right guard, so their line should be just about intact. It still will be tough going running the ball against the Vikings, but if Cousins has time to throw, the Redskins will put up some points. It may be tough for Josh Doctson to have a big game if he is locked up against Vikings cornerback Xavier Rhodes, but if Cousins now has faith in his catch radius, he could make a few key grabs. Perhaps I am underrating the Vikings, but I just think the Redskins are the better team and they should come out of this with a win at home. Redskins 28, Vikings 17. Predictions: record this year 35. Rich Tandler covers the team 365 days a year. Like his Facebook page, facebook.com/TandlerNBCs, and follow him on Twitter at TandlerNBCS. Tandler on Twitter: which Redskin is going to ball out Sunday? At TandlerNBCs, at JapeFinlayNBCs, and at ChickadNBCS. Debate that very question in arguing in circles. pick.twitter.com/4QD8P8W3, NBC Sports Redskins at NBCs Redskins November 11, 2017. In case you missed it, the Redskins have made some roster moves in advance of their game against the Vikings tomorrow. Up from the practice squad are Brandon Banks and WR Maurice Harris. Injuries have forced the team to get reinforcements in both of those positions. Without adding Banks, the Redskins would have gone into tomorrow's game with just four healthy defensive linemen. It was previously announced that Matt Ioannidis will miss the game with a broken hand. Arthur Jones, signed just a week ago to help on the defensive line, suffered a separated shoulder against the Seahawks and was put on injured reserve. More Redskins player O'Neal-INERSOFFENSE. The Redskins have two wide receivers who were listed as questionable, giving them an opportunity to bring up Harris. He played in 10 games last year, and while his opportunities were limited, he did take advantage of them, catching 8 passes for 66 yards. Harris serves as insurance if either Jamison Crowder or Brian Quick can't play. Crowder missed the Seattle game with a hamstring injury and he is questionable for this game. Quick also is questionable with a concussion. Although he has cleared the protocol, the Redskins are now covered in case there is a relapse or another issue. To make room for Harris, the Redskins waived G. Tyler Catalina. He started 2 games at right guard while Brandon Scherff was injured. This is a good sign that Scherff, who is listed as questionable, will be able to play. Related upset win boosts REDSINS and power rankings. Stay up to date on the Redskins. Rich Tandler covers the team 365 days a year. Like his Facebook page, facebook.com/TandlerNBCs, and follow him on Twitter at TandlerNBCS.